what we've been doing over and over again is focusing on that one thing or that one company that can come in and save us all. That is just not going to happen. It hasn't happened in the history of the United States. It's not going to happen in Kansas City. And if we're going to be competitive as a region, we need to get real about growing our people here and investing in our people. We do that, others are going to want to come. That's actually the history of economic development.
We have a lot of money in Kansas City, period. Purses are not opening and doing what is being required to make these bigger changes that we need. They have to put their money where their mouth is and make the difference.
It's interesting having a conversation about opportunity zones in the current climate, because they do feel like they were this big shiny new toy that we all had a year ago. And now, you know, in many ways our world hasn't changed so significantly. We're just looking at it differently. And in some ways it has changed so much.
Much of the urban core, and particularly neighborhoods that we work in, we already had pandemic-like symptoms going on already. We were already at 17-18%. In some areas, some zip codes as high as 22%. People were dying, yes, in the urban core before the pandemic. Banks are already slowing down on, you know, reviewing projects that were already in the pipeline. That's definitely not good for redevelopment in areas of the urban core.
The coronavirus pandemic is really making all of us urgently aware of how much more we need to invest in our Main Street and our frontline workforce. The small mom and pops, the things that make our communities very authentic, that give them that sense of character and uniqueness. We have to think about ways to use economic development tools to help them maintain their presence in our community, because without that, you know, we lose a lot of the character of our city and of our neighborhoods. Those pioneers and those champions that are there locally help provide stability. They recognize the beauty and the authenticity and the quality of that place. That's our future. Those are going to be the companies that are going to grow and that are going to create jobs as we emerge out of what is looking like a recession at this point.
We would move to just-in-time delivery on commerce in our logistics chain. We are now seeing almost overnight move to just-in-case logistics chains. And that's going to result in much larger distribution centers, much more complete manufacturing and logistics chains. And ultimately, in places like Kansas City, I think it should result in thousands of new quality jobs.
COVID is creating more need for opportunity zone capital than ever before, but there's probably less opportunity zone capital to go around because of it. Based on that you have to have capital gains, and I think there's less capital gains in the country right now, and that you've got this long-term lockup of the capital, that folks are really hungering for liquidity at this moment. Rather than being locked up in deals for a long period of time, what we will need and require is the overall economy, the overall markets to heal before Opportunity Zones comes back as strong as it was in 2019, or really stronger now that we have all the regulations. America's gonna need all of that and more to get going again.
Because of the couple of years that it really took for even large institutions and large law firms to really understand this tool, has already eaten a couple of years into with before projects get in the ground.
I think it was an opportunity missed, because now we're in year three of a 10-year scenario. Hey, we're moving on. You know, we've been around for 30 years. We've done deals without opportunity zone funding. I can't stop transforming the landscape of Kansas City because I can't get Opportunity Zone funding. I've got to find a way to keep going on, and that's what we've done.
Opportunity Zones, again, are a tool, right? They're another arrow in our quiver. So they're here whether or not we use them as a community. So let's put them in our pocket. Let's use them when we can. But they're not going to save the world. There are a lot of ways that we can invest in our community. And so ultimately, if we're looking at all the different forms of capital, whether it's philanthropy, private investment, public financing, you know, and pulling all of those together in creative ways and having conversations at a community level about what we want our communities to look like, then that's what really matters. And so we're going to continue doing that, whether or not opportunity zones gain traction or not.
There's hundreds of millions of dollars between city funds and philanthropic funds being invested on the east side currently. But residents aren't feeling it. How do you use a tool like this to get more private investment into an area that it hasn't before? What they're realizing is it's not the tool, it's the question. How do you get private investment into an area that it hasn't before? And that's what every community needs to focus on. How do we have a conversation that looks at unintended consequences of certain things? How do we have a conversation that looks at systematic issues that have been, you know, entrenched for 50 years around race, highway systems, all of the things that have led us to where we're at today? That means not just focusing in on one element, affordable housing and building housing. That means not just focusing on job development and focusing on workforce development. That doesn't mean just focusing on early education or high school. It means trying to get a more cohesive approach for all of those things. That's what I think this has to do with our community. Less about a tax break for people that have a capital gains event happen. And that's why as a foundation and as a coalition, we've moved beyond opportunity zones and thinking of that as more a tool in the toolbox versus the end result. The end result that we're shooting for is how do you build wealth within a community? And doing that means you use all the tools that you have available, including the Opportunity Zone tax credit, but focusing also on all of the other programming and pulling that into a more strategic approach.
We're not sure if Opportunity Zones is going to be here in the next 3, 5, let alone 10 years. We're beyond trying to figure out what an Opportunity Zone can really do or mean. The most important thing is a change in our community and making Kansas City a better Kansas City.